graduate of the first class that went all 3 years. I feel honored to speak about my dear friend, Frank Pitezel. We go back to junior high school. We entered Will Rogers for the first class to graduate all 3 years. Frank was very popular in sports and was a top-notch basketball player. He has always been held in high profile for helping other people. He and his lovely wife, Billie, hosted our reunion over many, many years. It was fun to go to their house. They did the same gracious gathering for Billie's class. They were living parents, loving parents to 9 children, raising them with the high standards Frank accomplished so much to the youth of Tulsa through church and various school activities. He has spent his entire life helping people. He kept the class of 1942 together by his efforts. No one who has ever met Frank will forget him. He is definitely a legend. I think you all are so lucky to be in this wonderful place. Thank you so much.
Frank Pitezel, class of 1942, was a sophomore at Will Rogers High School when the doors first opened in 1939. As a young man, Frank set his mind on 2 goals: to get the best education he could and to receive a college basketball scholarship. After studying hard and being part of the state basketball championship team in 1941, Frank was recruited by Hank Iba to play basketball at Oklahoma A&M, which later became Oklahoma State. Encouraged by the legendary coach to join the war effort, Frank enlisted and trained as an engineer. His platoon was involved in, among other things, the Battle of the Bulge, and Frank earned a Combat Bronze Star Medal and 3 Battle Stars. Upon returning to Tulsa, Frank married his high school sweetheart, Billie Marie Hall, and began his successful career for the Public Service Company of Oklahoma, where he worked as Director of Engineering Services. He and Billie had 9 children, and Frank spent his adult life working towards the goal of making Tulsa a better community for his family. Over the years, he has served in many church and community organizations, including the Junior Chamber of Commerce. He spearheaded the effort to build the four-plex Lighted Bear baseball stadium, and each year, 450 boys between the ages of 8 and 16 could play competitive baseball regardless of income or abilities. Frank became active in politics and in 1980 was elected to the Oklahoma State House of Representatives, where he served for 10 years. Ladies and gentlemen, please make a warm welcome for Frank Pitezel.
Good, you're all here. The guy back there asked me if I could talk loud enough so you could hear me. I happen to have been a platoon sergeant in the infantry, and you have to really speak loud to some of those people to get their attention. So, can you hear me at this rate?
Yes!
Thank you so very much. It's really something great for me to be here today. I came in 1939 in the southwest door of this building. Actually, I was a spy from Central. I lived two blocks inside the district. But all my friends came from Cleveland, and I snuck out here and didn't tell them. And so I did something wrong, but forgive me. I tried to be a good student here, except C-plus was about as good as I could do. I don't have a short time. But I'm 92 years old, probably in this auditorium. In this auditorium maybe only one time in my 3 years here. And I can't believe that it's a building that's known nationally. But I've got to move on because 3 minutes is going real fast. I have a lot to say. If you read the little, you have these things, I think, that has the outline, and you saw that. That's enough to bother your whole day. I want to thank the Hall of Fame group for allowing me to come to be with you. And I love people. I spent my entire life, after I got out of the service, serving people. And I hope that all of you will do that, because certainly our country needs you to serve them now. I just can't hardly say enough, but you realize that this school is 3/4 of a century old? Figure your math. You good math. Get your little deal. And figure that out. And I didn't realize it until I started. So I may have to talk a little bit. I better hurry on because I have one really important message for all the students personally. But everybody that's here will understand. And I'm going to leave with you one word in the vocabulary. And that word is can't. Have you ever said can't? Anybody in here that never said can't? I don't see any hands. See, if I could have talked to you back then, to the older folks, it would help them, but now maybe it's too late. But to the young folks out there, let me tell you how you can be successful by operating on that word, that nasty word, can't. It's the worst word ever put in the dictionary. Mark it out. You know, if you get in the dictionary, just mark it out. But here's what I want to say to you, how you spell can't. I think it's C-A-N apostrophe T. Well, I suggest if you want to be successful, you take the apostrophe T out, and take the T out, and then you throw it in the trash and move around over and get behind what's left and what is left. Hands! Think about that, all you young folks. Don't say you can't. You put yourself down to start with. If you don't put that word in there, you're going uphill to go. That's something I hope you will take with you if you don't remember anything else I've said. I have a lot to say, but it's in the bulletin here, and I thank the foundation for allowing me to come today, and I thank my maker for letting me be here too. And I know that all the people that I've worked with deserves part of this award today to me. And I won't be able to thank all of them, but I have a way to do it. And you know how I'm going to do that? I'm going to let my maker and his son say thanks to everybody that's helped me in my life. That is what I'd like to leave with. And one more thing, I guess I can go on. My 3 minutes have been about 10. But I have a wife that's been a big part for 7 years. And bless her heart, she's not here today because she's ill. But we've had a good time and a good life. Enjoy this school. What a magnificent building. No place in the world has a building like this. And if you hear of anyone who speaks badly about it, punch them in the nose. Tell them, hey, you don't know what you're talking about. This school is the greatest school in the United States. It's on the register. You'll never be torn down. Unless God does it. Your God. Oh, my God. I think I'll close by saying, with me, will you say, go, great girl!